Welcome to our melting pot.
To the 80s.
The most rad decade ever.
The 80s was really great for the both of us because we were born during this time.
That's right. Today we're going to make for you guys some dishes that were popularized in the 80s. I'm going to make for you guys one of my childhood favorites, something my mom used to make for me time to time. And that's a 7-layer dip. What are you going to make?
I'm going to make ambrosia salad, a dessert that we always ate at family gatherings in my family.
All right. Well, let's get started. What are you going to start with, hon? I'll let you go first.
Okay. I am going to start with, the bananas. It's so much that goes into this fruit salad. It's a lot of fruit. So I'm gonna take these off so I can really
That's my favorite get part into of the
the gloves. Well, okay. I'm gonna add 2 bananas into this fruit salad.
Chop those bad boys
up. I'm gonna chop up these bananas.
Look at those knife skills, everybody.
Let me get the next banana.
One thing I loved about the 80s was the clothes.
Yes.
I mean, we look back now and like we used to look at how we dressed and how our parents dressed, and it's silly looking. But I mean.
Big hair.
Bright
makeup. As you guys can see, I'm wearing this bright eyeshadow. I usually don't wear eyeshadow this bright. I'm neutral, but we had to get into character.
Every generation just has their own thing, their style, and sometimes you look back and go, what the hell was that?
But you couldn't tell our moms that they weren't cute.
Right, exactly.
They look good. Big hair, lots of hairspray, and frizz.
Lots a lot of frizz.
Mm-hmm. And the guys.
Aquanet.
How's the guys' hair?
Wasn't it Aquanet?
Aquanet.
Yeah, the guys, like, I had the 80s metal guys had the long hair like this.
Yes.
And the bangs. Cool bangs.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think any man should ever have bangs, but hey, who am I to judge?
Oh, don't make me laugh.
All right. Well, I think I'll get started with some of mine. First layer I'm gonna do, as I get my long hair out of the way, is some refried beans. Now these are homemade refried beans. All I did was I took some beef fat. The other day we made a brisket, and I trimmed some of the brisket off. And all I did, if you want to make your own beef tallow, take those trimmings. Put them in the oven in a pan on like 250 to 275 and just let it sit there for hours, and all that fat you can just drain it through a little ramekin or a bowl, and it becomes just like beef tallow you buy at the store.
Uh-huh. So amazing. So much flavor. Mm-hmm. And now I'm adding my apples, everyone. Granny Smith apples.
Does it have to be Granny Smith?
It can be. It's best for it to be a sweet apple. That way, you know, it's kind of like a dessert.
Right.
It's sweet. Some people say it's a fruit salad dessert, but we always ate it after we were done eating dinner, along with the pies and the cake. So I consider it a dessert.
Your family loves their pies and their cakes.
Yes, especially in the South. We got you hooked to the desserts.
Not funny.
In your family, you weren't used to eating desserts like until you came to the South.
Yeah, we're not big dessert eaters. I mean, we eat them at, you know, get-togethers, Thanksgiving and Christmas. But other than that, I mean, it was never my thing. I tried to avoid diabetes, but maybe that's just me. No, I'm kidding.
Moderation is all about
everything's
moderation.
Everything's about moderation.
Yes.
That's right. So I'm trying to spread this out to an even layer.
That's looking good.
These beans are delicious.
Yes.
It's simple. I just took the beef tallow, then I toasted some cumin seeds in there first, and then I put in about a quarter of a red onion and a clove of garlic, and then I put in a can of black beans, drained the black beans, put them in here, let them roast down, and just took a masher. Mm-hmm. And you just get very, very tasty.
Yes.
Refried beans. Homemade refried beans are the best.
Yes, you can never go wrong with beans.
So my next layer here is gonna be this ground chicken. Same thing, I'm using chicken today because I've been eating a lot of beef this week. My wife forced me to eat a tomahawk ribeye the other day that was about an inch thick. Plus we had the brisket on Sunday and Monday, so.
I forced you.
Yes.
Oh dear.
Can't be good for
throwing me under the bus, why don't.
Everybody will eat this anyways. Go ahead, honey.
Yes. Okay, now I'm going to add some grapes. green grapes. I hope they're sweet because my husband picked them out on yesterday. So I hope you got some sweet grapes, no sour grapes.
They were on sale.
Okay. So I don't know. We'll find out once we eat this dish to see how sweet, how well my husband did.
Okay. I know I did a good job. I always do.
Yes.
Right, Dylan? That's right.
Now I'm going to add some fruit cocktail, but I will drain the juice. We don't want it too juicy, but maybe a little bit of juice in it for the flavor.
Sounds like a plan.
Again, I see my husband, he got lightly sweetened fruit cocktail, so I don't know.
One of my least favorite things about fruit cocktail cans is that syrup they come in. It's like, to me, that's just so wrong. It's like, you got this healthy fruit, and then you soak it in this like overly sweet syrup that cannot be healthy whatsoever.
This makes the ambrosia. Just watch Edward Scissorhands.
Yes, if you've never seen Edward Scissorhands, that's what makes you think of ambrosia. That lady, her ambrosia, her famous ambrosia salad.
Yes.
That's what I love.
It was, yes.
Justice for Johnny. Justice for Johnny.
Go, Johnny. Okay. And now, this is about a cup of marshmallows, mini marshmallows. You don't want the big ones. I know this too, some people, they add the colorful marshmallows. I prefer the white. And Edward Scissorhands, they have the colorful marshmallows, I think. But yeah, so never tried them that way. Just used to my family making it with the white marshmallows. All right, and now about a cup of coconut.
A cup of coconut.
Sweet or unsweetened. You all can just, you know, choose and decide which one you prefer to go into your ambrosia.
My next thing is gonna be this layer of guacamole. This is just very simple guacamole. I just, 4 avocados and some cilantro and lime juice, salt and pepper, and that's it.
You make the best guacamole, honey. Oh, and I'm not just saying that because you're my husband.
Well, good answer. Good answer.
All right. And now I'm going to add some sour cream. I also noticed that some people, they prefer Cool Whip, but I'm gonna change it up a bit.
Cool Whip.
I'm gonna change it up a bit and I'm gonna put both. My family usually puts just sour cream in it. I think it's my Aunt Barbara and my cousin Vanessa that usually brings it, the ambrosia, and they do such a great job. Oh my God. And I'm thinking it's sour cream that they put in it. If not, I'm sorry guys, but I'm adding the Cool Whip as well. But anyway, too, I also wanted to add your ambrosia is always delicious. My cousin Vanessa's and my Aunt Barbara's ambrosia is always amazing. I hope mine is as good as theirs.
Oh, I'm sure it will be.
Okay, now I'm gonna add the whole container of sour cream. It's been so long since I made ambrosia, but it's gonna be very refreshing today for us.
Very refreshing.
Next, I'm gonna add my sour cream to it. I'm gonna do a layer on my, so I have the refried beans on the bottom, the ground turkey, now the guacamole. As you can see, those layers start to form on there. Look at that.
Nice. Right.
Now the sour cream.
I'm about to start talking about the colors. I love those colors. I know I'm always saying that during our videos, the colors, but colors just make such a statement when you're cooking. Yeah. It can add beauty.
Well, eating is, you know, when you eat, you look. First thing you do is you look at it. If it looks appetizing, you're gonna want to eat it.
Yes, exactly. You don't want a bland-looking dish. So colors just add so much to the eye. All right.
Go
ahead. Okay. Oh, dropping oranges. I forgot to add the oranges, so now I'm gonna add that on top. It's gonna be a big ambrosia.
Ooh.
Go ahead, honey. Your turn.
Okay, and I'm doing my sour cream, but I was going to say the movies in the 80s. There's some great movies that came out in the 80s.
Yes, there really was. What was your favorite?
Everybody knows. Dylan, what's my favorite movie?
The Goonies.
The Goonies.
That's yes.
The Goonies came out. There was Die Hard, Karate Kid. What were some of your favorites, son?
My favorite, Coming to America.
Oh, classic Eddie Murphy.
Love, love, love.
Beverly Hills Cop.
Yes, Nightmare on Elm Street. Don't forget about the holiday classics from the
80s. Christmas Vacation.
Yes, we have to watch that every year around the holidays.
That's a good one.
Go Chevy.
Chevy.
Chevy was
back in the day.
Chase, yes. Okay, and also guys, I am going to make this fruit cocktail a little bit sweeter. I'm gonna add a little bit of sugar. My dad's supposed to be coming by this evening to have some. I know he's gonna be upset because he's gonna be like, sugar? Why add sugar when it's all these fruits in here that already add natural sugar? But
wait till he finds out all the amounts of MSG I put in this. Hector loves his MSG. I'm kidding.
Okay, this is about a teaspoon of sugar. But in the South, you can never have too much sugar.
I know. I noticed. All right, my next layer is going to be this homemade pico de gallo. Now, you could do just regular tomatoes, or you could, you know, make some pico de gallo. I mean, it's always better if you go that little extra mile, let it sit. This is just some tomato, some jalapeno, and some cilantro, and a little bit of red onion, salt, and pepper, and lime juice. Now, it's best if you sit, let it sit for a while. And when making pico de gallo, always use just the flesh of that tomato. Don't use the soft inside part. That way you don't get all that mushiness and like has more crunch.
Yes.
And you just take that off and you smell it.
I smell it from here.
Exactly. It's just
I wish you all were here to smell this, but you
delicious.
Can definitely make this on your own. That's why you have to keep watching us.
Yes, exactly.
Support.
And when you're cooking, what I always tell Gerald as she's cooking, I always say, best thing to do, think WWJD. What would Jason do when you're cooking? Would he do that? If not, don't do it. Don't do it.
Look at you tooting your own horn.
I know. It's disgusting. Disgusting.
Okay, now I'm going to add some vanilla. Imitation. I know. I'm not doing an Ina Garten. I'm not doing a natural vanilla. Ina, if you're watching this, you'll be so ashamed of me. But
we love you, Ina. You're
the best. We love you. So I'm going to add a little bit of splash. Splash of this. And next. Some ground cinnamon. A little bit
of that ground cinnamon.
Yes. You can never have too much of moderation with cinnamon, but it adds such a burst Yes. Okay, now I'm gonna mix this all up. I don't think I'm missing anything. Might just have to add more Cool Whip.
Cool Whip.
Happy I went with the big bowl. I was gonna go with the smaller bowl.
You wanted
bowl.
A smaller bowl. You were like, honey, you think this is gonna be too big? And I'm like, no.
Lots and lots of fruit.
Mm-hmm. Now, one thing I was gonna do with this, and I was telling Linda, is like, I was gonna add, you see a lot of people add lettuce to it, and that's one of their seven layers, but I don't, because it's like, you can use this the next day. So if you add lettuce, that lettuce is gonna wilt.
It will.
You're gonna have soggy lettuce on it. Nobody's gonna want a soggy lettuce dip the next day. That's just like, ugh.
You're not. It's a good idea. And it's, with all those layers as is, it's like, I don't even think you really missed the lettuce.
No.
Did your mom?
She would add lettuce sometimes.
Okay, but it varied?
But I mean, it was very good with the lettuce, but tomorrow, first game of the football season tomorrow, so I mean, I'm gonna eat some of this.
Yes.
Next, I'm gonna put on a layer of cheese, everybody. So this is a small layer of cheese. And then I remember Die Hard was that 80s movie that defined all action movies.
Yeah.
You know, it's like everybody was like, every character was like John McClane after that. The sole cop who was saving the world. So badass.
Yes, and I think when we're done tonight, our movie is going to be 80s movies. We're going to find a bunch of movies.
We're going to watch Rad. You guys remember watching Rad? Woo! I grew up watching that. Me and my neighborhood friends.
It's a cute movie, but you had me watch that already about a year ago.
There's nothing wrong with watching it once a year.
Well, I was thinking more of Edward Scissorhands. I feel like watching something that has my dish that I'm making today.
Oh, okay. Oh,
so
yeah.
I'm gonna watch.
My last layer, is gonna be the Black Olives. Sprinkle these all over.
Okay. Nice.
Seven layers, people.
Wow.
And we'll turn it to the side and you can get a good shot. Excuse me. I think olive went down the wrong tube.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, I'm just choking.
Need some water? Oh, stop.
Just having a heart attack.
Oh, goodness.
All right.
I don't know what to sprinkle on top. All the colors are peeking through. I want it to look pretty for everyone. Maybe I should sprinkle some cinnamon on top?
Yeah,
what do you think?
Powder or some cinnamon on top.
Yes.
Now look at that. Look at all those layers.
Ooh, that's beautiful. Ooh. What a beauty.
That's layers. Okay. Just layers of flavor.
Yay. Okay, everyone. Now I'm going to add some add the finishing touches to my dish. A little bit of cinnamon.
All right.
Okay, and I'm gonna show you all. Pretty, right,
very
everyone?
Pretty, very
and
pretty.
And put it in the fridge to chill.
Chill. Yeah. All right, welcome back, everybody.
Hi, everybody.
We're all finished.
That's
go ahead.
Okay, I'm sorry, honey. Another thing I forgot to add was the pecans. Pecans is a must as well in this ambrosia. So now I'm just gonna sprinkle.
Definitely in the south. Pecans.
Pecans make it crunchy. It adds that crunch to the ambrosia.
Should we taste? I'm just gonna dip mine in there.
I am so ready.
I don't even need
to
use a spoon.
This amazing
I just wanna
dish. Okay, I'm gonna dip too. You be on that end. I'll be on this end. Get all that seven layer. You're gonna break a chip.
I don't know if the chips can even stand up to it.
I know. That's delicious.
Wow. That's really, really good.
It really is.
I don't think I got meat in there. Now I got the beans and the meat on them. That's hearty.
Okay, now I'm going to try some of this ambrosia.
How is it? Good?
So good.
It looks good. I'm just not a big fruit dessert person. I'm sorry, everybody.
And he's been living in the South for a while.
I've been living in the South. I'll never get used to eating desserts and all that stuff. Not my thing. Well, thank you, everybody. We appreciate you. We love you.
Bye.
Hit the like button. Hit subscribe. Bye.
Bye.
Rock and roll.
80s style.
See you next Saturday.
Yeah. See you next Saturday.
Yes. Bye.